It's AumSum time!
Why is hot water harmful for fish?
No, who doesn't like a hot water bath?
No, AumSum. Hot water is harmful for fish.
But why?
Most fish use oxygen dissolved in water for respiration and metabolism. However, solubility of gases decreases with increase in temperature. Hence, as the water gets warmer, less oxygen begins to dissolve in water, making it hard for the fish to breathe. Also, as temperature increases, the fish's metabolism increases, in turn increasing the oxygen requirement. Eventually, there won't be enough oxygen for the fish, causing it to suffocate and maybe die. Hence, if you have an aquarium, you should always check and maintain its water temperature. You can also use a filter or bubbler which helps add and circulate oxygen, thus maintaining your fish's health.
What makes ice clear or cloudy?
At home, we generally use room temperature tap water to make ice. At room temperature, water has many dissolved minerals, gases, etc., which are invisible to our naked eyes. On freezing this water, its temperature starts dropping and ice starts to form from outside. Hence, the minerals and gases no longer remain dissolved. But as they cannot escape out, they get pushed towards the unfrozen center. Eventually, when the center freezes, the trapped minerals and gases become visible, making ice cloudy.
Will it rain from the cloudy ice?
Oh, just listen. Now, to avoid the situation, some specialized ice makers make ice slowly layer by layer. In this technique, water is made to continuously flow over the surface of a cool container. Thus, water begins to freeze from the bottom of the container, layer by layer, giving the minerals and gases time to escape from the top, making ice clear. What if we stop drinking water?
We will have to sell our water purifiers to scrap dealers.
Ugh, you are unbelievable. About 60% to 80% human body is water. We need water for various purposes like digestion and excretion. Water is also a major component of blood. However, every day we lose about 2 to 3 liters of water through sweat, urine, breathing, etc. Hence, to compensate the water loss, if we don't drink enough water, then we will get dehydrated. During dehydration, our brain works harder than normal. It informs kidneys to retain moisture, thus producing darker concentrated urine. It reduces the production of saliva, causing dry mouth. Lack of water also causes our brain tissues to shrink. We get headaches and feel nauseous. Our energy levels drop and our skin becomes dry. Besides this, chronic dehydration can lead to severe health problems and even death. How do migratory birds find their way?
With the help of GPS.
No. Every year, many migratory birds fly thousands of kilometers to find food, to avoid extreme weather, etc. But researchers don't know how these birds find their way and travel to the same location year after year. However, an observation suggests that migratory birds can detect the Earth's magnetic field lines that appear to emerge from South Pole and merge into North Pole. When migratory birds have to travel from north to south, or vice versa, they align themselves with the magnetic field lines and travel to their location. Along with this, migratory birds may also find their way by creating a mental map of their route using mountains, rivers, etc. Besides this, it is also believed that migratory birds use the location of the sun and stars to find their way and reach the same location.